I remember it being very meaningful. I'm not quite sure. I'm not quite sure when at this point, but I'm just about to start doing rehearsal for a play in London, and I've been working on a couple other projects that have been in my life for a while, just trying to get a couple things off the ground. And here, taking readings for various things.
Year three, Entertainment Weekly critic Ken Tucker compared us favorably to The Twilight Zone. And I remember all of the writing staff saying that he got it. And it was like for me and for Chris, and most of us, Twilight Zone was like, still is, you know, what you aspire to. And to be compared to that show, to even be compared to it was such a huge compliment. And that's when I thought, wow, we really have a chance to make a mark here.
There was one thing about shooting up in Vancouver is that we were really kind of sheltered from a lot of the, what turned out to be, you know, mania around it in the rest of the world. And so we didn't really, you know, we were just kind of our heads down, we were working, we were doing photo shoots on weekends, and it wasn't until, you know, at some point I lifted my head up and said, well, we've had a photo shoot for the last 6 weekends and I keep doing interviews and people seem to like it and maybe it's doing okay. You know, it took me a while to realize that. But once we did, it was kind of like, you know, sometimes when you're in the middle of that kind of thing, you can't even fathom what it is. I don't think I really fathomed it until we were finished, until even 2 years after we were finished. And all of a sudden I started going, is a big deal. Yeah, but I'm fixed, so somebody else would have gotten it a long time ago.
Did you guys have begin having fans showing up in Vancouver, you know, trying to catch all working?
But we were so kind of elusive and it's kind of hard to, we didn't have like loads of, sometimes people would fly in and at the gate of some remote place that we were shooting, there'd be a clump of people.
I'll tell you, it was weird. I went up in August to cover something for something that was being filmed at North Shore. Mm. I finally got to go there for the first time. I just, this was their home. And everywhere you turn, it's like you could see an X-Files exterior scene. It's like they must have shot something here.
It's pretty weird. There was a lot of deja vu happening. But for me, deja vu is like, film here. Yeah, we shot 16 episodes this week. Anyway, I'm gonna go. Thanks, you guys.
We just turned our stuff in, and then the production staff did that.
Is that what Chris's field was when he did that?
No, he did that writing.
You know what? That's a great idea, and I'll suggest that to the publisher. We put it online so they.
Oh, that's a smart idea.
Just
the page is missing.
The page
is missing.
Ah,
yeah.
I didn't.
No,
I'm not saying.
Well, I am. You thought it was your book, actually.
Page 69 seems to be missing. That's the way run, guys, right?
Yeah,
it does. It stops, and then it goes to the next chapter.
I think it may just be missing the end of the sentence.
So, Frank, are there any cool stories, like, behind the scenes? Like, we love that stuff. Like, we talk about all that. No, I'm just kidding. Oh, we kind of do. But we wanted to know, like, are there any cool stories that you remember that are funny, witty, I don't know, something?
Nothing funny or witty ever
happened. Oh. I knew it.
No. You know, it's sort of like, Jillian, it all becomes like a haze.
Yeah.
But if somebody asks something specific, sometimes it triggers a memory of something that I may have forgotten otherwise.
Like during filming, did David do something funny, or Jillian, or, I don't know, kind of mess up a film because they did something?
Well, frequently, David is ad-libbing and trying to come up with funny lines or funny situations, and frequently he's being shot down, and they tell you can't. It's not appropriate for you to be funny in this particular situation. But no specific examples come to mind, I'm sorry. All right, if there's no other burning questions, I guess we'll go over. Anybody else?
When does part two come out of the book?
Good question.
There were a lot of things that I know you guys wanted to put in there, but we're not able to. So when's part two?
Stay tuned. I want to tell you, I mean, it was a really great experience doing this thing. I mean, to go through, particularly, I mean, not only getting to know all these people, you know, talking to Frank and Tim Manners and Bowman and all the actors and everything. It's just so great to hear their stories, and there are a lot of stories. And it was the thing I kept in mind, and I used to actually publish a Beatles fanzine. And I know the way we fans think. You know? And you know, when I was very lucky I got to go through the Fox photo archive and find all these pictures. And just to, you know, whenever we would come across, you know, a great one of, here's Kim sitting with David at the desk. The fans are going to love it. We have to have. Anytime we found these pictures, we always had you people in mind. And, you know, we know how much you all love this, and you really were who we did it for.
Thank you.
That being said,
who planned the inserts?
Lisa Fitzpatrick, who is our editor. She edited, I was hoping she'd get to be here. But she really was the driving force behind the book and the way it was executed. I just kept cramming, flying through doing interviews. I think this time last year, I was thinking about this morning, I think I was in the middle of watching season 8. You know, I was watching like 4 to 6 episodes a day. And then, like I said, I run across one and call him up. I'm like, Frank, this is the coolest thing I've ever seen. And he was like, yeah, that's a good one. And, but we just kept coming up with one thing we were hoping would happen, and it's sort of, we wanted to put one cockroach just one randomly any place in the book.
Oh, that's anything.
Well, we wanted to just have one someplace because you all would get it.
Right.
You know? That would be scary. Just randomly. Because that's the way it appears in the episode. It just randomly goes across the screen for no good reason. But Lisa came up with these ideas, and there's a lot of story still to be told about how they created how they would do the writing and how they would create the stories. And that's where you see some of Chris's story cards, how the whole process of breaking a story and how that's a really interesting part, I think. There's a lot of filmmaking story here still.
But, you know, Matt did an absolutely exhaustive, Matt Beck.
Hey.
We all know who you are. Matt did an incredibly exhaustive job of interviewing everybody episode by episode. I mean, really hours. And what is in this book is just a small percentage of the work that he did. So we have talked about not a book like this, a different format book that would take advantage of all the work, especially like he did hours and hours of interviews with Kim Manners, unfortunately. And so
he went through every episode. And it was an amazing thing because it's the creative people like the writers and the directors. And you know, you were one of those. I mean, they remember every single detail, and I had so little time, I got who I could get. I didn't get to talk to Matt, and there's loads of visual effects stories to tell. Loads that make there's little effects that make the episode creepy that'll get you. You know, that did. And it's funny, the actors often, Jillian. I mean, like she was. I think you got a sense of that from what she was saying. You know, for the actors, it's It's a daily, they get their sides, what they call the script pages for the day. They study those up, they go to work, they mash through those from where they get, what time did they start up? The call was 7 o'clock or something?
Well, it's Monday morning, they're getting to work at 5 or 6 in the morning.
Yeah.
And by Friday evening, they're reporting to work at 4 or 5 in the afternoon. Mm. And then finishing at, you know, 4 or 5 on Saturday morning, then going back to work again on Monday at 5 o'clock in the morning.
And, so and they're not shooting, as you probably know about filmmaking, they're not shooting necessarily in continuity, where they're not starting at the beginning of the episode on Monday and finishing with it on Friday. They're doing their day's thing, and it's hard. It's a whole different, you know, life they have to lead. So it's hard for the actors to remember, you know, if I mention a specific episode, it's hard for them to, she's like, I just did my work every day. That's what I knew, you know. That's a whole different thing, and you know, it was interesting to learn about that, that that's what they had to go through. And she'd get home late at night after all that and then study up her pages for tomorrow. And there was some technical jargon, you know.
All right, we're going to go sides.
Okay.
Thank you so much
for all the work. I
know a lot of friends.
Have you?
Really?
Okay. Here,
we live
now.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
My law school is a long
time no see. Thank you for the movie.
So you liked it?
Yeah, I didn't know.
It was my kind of file.
Like you be.